Hi, in this video we are looking at fixing on automatic repair loop couldn't repair your PC. We have 5 solutions that we can try in this video. Hi guys, my name is Ramesh and welcome to Easy Classes. Before fixing the automatic repair couldn't repair your PC or automatic repair the PC did not start correctly, then we have to find the reasons. There are 4 reasons may creating this error. The first reason is sudden power loss or power outages happens suddenly. The second reason, Windows registry errors. The third reason may boot file corruptions. And the fourth reason may missing or damaged system files. Yes guys, we are going to look into these reasons and working on these reasons to solve the issue. Okay, let's jump to the solutions. First solution, startup repair loop. Go to the advanced options, then find troubleshoot, click on that and select advanced options. Now select startup repair. This option will automatically find the errors and fixing for you. Now if your system not started correctly, then it will start to show startup repair couldn't repair your PC error. Don't worry, we have other solutions to perform. Second solution, get system restore. To restore your PC, go to the advanced options, troubleshoot, advanced options and select system restore. Then it will start to find the system restore files. If you didn't find any restore points, then it will show the error. If you have any restore point, it will ask you to next and install it. So then go to the next and install. In my case, I don't have any system restore files, so I will quit it. Third solution, fixing the boot file corruptions. To fix the boot file corruptions, go to the advanced options, select troubleshoot, again advanced options and select command prompt. Now we have opened command prompt. So this is the big step, then follow with me. Type chkdesk space /f/or /c:. Then press enter. Then it will start to automatically check the physical disk and finding the errors. If there is any physical errors, then it will fixing for you. Yes, the disk checkup has been completed. Now type disk part, then press enter. Now type list all, then press enter. It will list the volumes on your system. Now type SEL space VOL space 0. Now we have selected the volume 0, then type assign space letter space Z, then press enter. Now we have just assigned a letter to the 0 volume. Now type list volume, then press enter. Now you can see we have a renamed letter to the volume 0. Like this, you can rename the other volumes. Now exit. Now we have exited the disk part, then type bcd boot space /windows /s/z/f/all, then press enter. Now you can see the boot records here. Here you can see that we have typed bcd boot /windows. So this will initializes the system partition by using bcd files from the /windows folder, and we have typed forward yes. So this will bcd boot copies the boot files to either the system partition or the partition specified by the /s options. Then we have typed /f. This will specify the firmware type. When you specify the all value, bcd boot creates both the boot and the EFI Microsoft boot directories and copies all required boot environment files for BIOS and UEFI to those directories. So then type bootrec space /fixmbr to create new boot record. Just press enter. Now type bootrec space fixboot. This will fixes boot partition issues. Then press enter. Now type bootrec space /rebuild bcd. Then it will fixes installed OS files. Then press enter. Now type exit. So now you can see we have successfully worked on the boot file corruptions. Then hit on the continue. If the error is persistent, then try with the next solution, that is fixing the registry files. To fix the registry files, go to the troubleshoot again and select advanced files, then select command prompt once more. Now type disk part, then press enter. Now we are in the disk part mode. Then type list volume, then press enter. So we have listed the volumes here. Now if you don't find where is the OS has installed, so if you confused, then type exit to exit the disk part. Now type C colon, then press enter. Now type dir, then press enter. Now we are in the C drive. You can see the OS files has installed here. Now type cd backslash windows backslash system32 backslash config, then press enter. Now type dir, then enter. Then type md space backup 1, then enter. Then type copy space star dot store space backup 1, then enter. You know, 11 files is copied to the backup folder. Here the copy command will backup and copy the configuration folder files to the backup one folder. Now type cd space regback, then press enter. Now type dir, then press enter. Now you can see these are the values 0 showing. It should not be show 0. It should show some values here. So to fix this, type copy space star dot star space dot dot, then press enter. Now it will ask you to select yes, no or all. Now select all files, then press enter. Now we have copied the all files. Now type exit, then press enter. Then hit on the continue to continue with the boot. Once the system is booted successfully, then go to the Windows search bar and type registry editor. You will find registry editor, open that. In the registry editor, find hkey local machine, click on that. Now select system, double click on that. Now select control current set, double click on that and select control. Now find session manager, here it is, double click on that. Now select configuration manager, double click on that. Now in the right side, right click and select new and select dword 32 bit value. Now rename it as enable periodic backup, then press enter. Now right click on the file and select modify, and in the value data change it to 1, then press OK. This will automatically take the registry backup for you. That's it guys, hope this video helped you. If you like this video, please consider subscribing to our channel and hit the bell icon. I will meet you in the next exciting video like this. Till then, take care.